But I'm sure, if you have seen Madison, Angus Madison, he's a British economic historian. He has calculated the GDPs of various countries starting in the 1st century AD. So really, in his study, he mentioned that now in 1600 to 1800, India was contributing up to 25 to 21% of world GDP. But we have gone down. Maybe you know, some people blame it on colonialism and then British have colonized us as you know 200 years. I believe after that now we have gone to a stage where you know we were contributing minuscule percentage to world's. But now with those old strengths, I think it is again emerging. India is emerging. India is taking its own strengths are someone called we are now unleashing the tiger spirits in Indian economy. I think that is happening. Only these 2 years, people say external factors not so much, but even internal factors were a reason for India's the lack of growth during the last years. But I'm sure, I'm confident, the Indian policy makers and then the external economic powers who are looking at India as a market, who is looking at the middle income group which is burgeoning at a fast pace in India. At one time we used to have a 50 million middle income group kind of thing. Today it has bulged to around 450 to 500 million. So, and it is increasing. Thanks to the technology, thanks to the education systems in India, now you find every top 100 companies of the world having a shop in India, and which is welcome for India, and that itself is growing this middle income group in India. Only thing we lacked at was the manufacturing sector. Manufacturing sector, we couldn't progress much. I must confess that we still between 12 to 15%, which should have been around 30%, because of various reasons which I'll come a bit later. Education and HR in India, some Swiss company, I don't know to name, but they have recently went and expanded their facility. You don't believe, they came back and told me that they didn't look for HR outside. They were able to get the required HR. Really, they wanted really professional, highly competent human resource personnel for expanding by 2,500. So they could get within India, they could get economically, and one calls it's a kind of outsourcing, but it is a win-win situation. For them it is economical, for India it is employment, and for the company, it's a growth, not only in Switzerland, but in India. So we have 46 national universities, several state, hundreds of state universities, which produce engineers. I was just having a chat, you people have practical experience. I must confess, in India, some critic wrote that it's all paper engineers. Maybe it's possible, but the trend in Indian universities also is changing. It is no worth making a person a graduate in engineering, a graduate in science with a certificate. It is not enough. But let us go with the practicality of the education. So that is catching up. I am sure the companies which will set up in India will easily be able to get the required personnel. Population, it has been increasing, and then people say that by 2025 we will cross even China to become the largest populated country on the earth. But earlier we used to think that the population is really a liability, and now with the population of 65% under 35 is a great strength. We don't have the of course, as you grow, maybe we will also have the senior citizens as a making significant part of our population, but at present, maybe for 15 to 20 years more, we will have this ratio of below 35 age, we have about 65%, which provides the, you know, HR for whole world, may not be for only India, for whole world looks for such human resource pool. So India will have that human resource pool. No, I have been only, you know, gloating about India, but I must tell you, India, there are social inequalities, which, you know, we agree. Within India also, we criticize our own government, we criticize our own policies. We have such a democratic principle that, no, we don't want to prison or anything for criticizing the government. So social inequalities are such that, no, slowly the poverty, which was, no, 50 to 60% about, no, 1770s, now we have come down to between 25 and 30%. We have several programs. Some Swiss students have studied also. It is called rural unemployment, rural employment programs, etc., which are really, you know, helping to bring people up. And we have recently made education a fundamental right. So every child has to go to school based on that. Earlier we didn't have that, no, child, the right to education. We have right to education now. And through that, no, these social inequalities are going, mainly in our economy also. If you see our fiscal deficit, or if you see current account deficit, we go a bit low on it, just because we have several social programs to help people under the poverty line, below the poverty line.